So you see, to impart delight, you have to be more or less delightful. And to be delightful is to do things that are delightful to you. You become thereby delightful to others. That's to say, people who are interesting are people who are interested. Any person, for example, who is constantly thinking about all sorts of other things and other people and so on, because they're fascinating, becomes a fascinating person. So in other words, your engagement with the external world, the more you are involved, the more your personality is enriched.
Within hours of riding here, you can ride from the Amazon jungle over the top of 14,000 foot pass, and then down into the coastal plains and onto the beach. Amazing amount of diversity, and with that diversity of terrains comes diversity of climate, comes diversity of culture, diversity of cuisine. So there's a lot to see and a lot to do. It's what makes it a very special place to visit. In 2008, Savan and I set out on a long odyssey, and we rode from New York down to Buenos Aires, and the goal for us was to find a place to start our business. We looked at every different country along the way. We visited 16 different countries, and we kept coming back to Ecuador. We kept saying, you know, Ecuador is the place we felt the best, where we knew the country had a lot to offer. Diversity of terrain, one of the safest, the friendliest people, and we just knew we had to start the business here. We live and we ride here all year long, so what this means is we have an in-depth knowledge that just can't be matched by anybody else. We focus on really knowing a country extremely well and being able to share that knowledge. So it's about experiencing as much as we can, both on and off the bike. Country, you've got to meet the people, and so we strive to get you to meet people from many different walks of life. People who are making bricks, they're working on leather, they're fishermen, they're gold miners, all different types of life, so you can really get a good feeling for the way of life and the people here. Particular about the hotels that we look for. They've got to have some soul, they've got to have some personality to them. Most importantly, we need to make sure that we have a good night's rest, a very good shower and that there's access to good food. We want everybody to be well nourished and ready to enjoy a full day of riding. Getting here is very easy if you're coming from the United States and Canada. There's really no time difference. You may use the United States dollar. It's a real simple trip to take. We know this country. We speak the language. We know people all over the country. And we're really intent on showing you the best this country has to offer.
Trip of a lifetime. I would do it again in a heartbeat.